Hello, kids. Have you ever tried talking to someone in a really noisy place? Or how about trying to talk to someone who's really distracted? It's not easy to communicate with people when you don't have their full attention, is it? I wonder how God feels when He has something important to communicate to us, but we're too busy to listen. For instance, what if God has written us an important message on this paper? Can you read it? Neither can I. We can't receive God's messages when we're too busy and distracted. Today, we are talking about listening to God. Learning to listen to God is something that's immensely important for all of us because God has important things to say. In Psalm 46, verse 10, God says, "Be still and know that I am God." So it's hard to be still when we're too busy and distracted, isn't it? So the first step in listening to God is to take time to be still and to give Him our full attention. And don't let anything get in the way of that time between you and God. After you've set aside some time, the next step is to have a place where you can be quiet and free from distractions. It might be a corner of your bedroom, or it might be a comfy chair in the living room. I know sometimes I am so distracted that I actually have to go sit in my dark closet. God doesn't mind meeting with me there. After all, He met with Jonah in the smelly belly of a fish. The important thing is that you find a place where you can be alone. And then the next step is to let God in. God speaks to us through His words in the Bible and through the Holy Spirit. So when you're sitting quietly, spend time reading God's word, and then close your eyes, cover your ears if you have to, and just enjoy being in God's presence. That is when the Holy Spirit can relay God's messages to you. You see, the Holy Spirit is kind of like this lamp. The Holy Spirit illuminates God's words for us. Now, can you read God's message? You are valuable and loved by God. That is a message we don't want to miss. So, learning to listen to God takes time and effort, but it's worth it because really, there is no one more important for us to hear from. Let's pray. Okay. Heavenly Father, You always want what's best for us, but we cannot know what that is unless we can hear from You. Please help us to form the habit of taking time to listen to You so that we can recognize Your voice and receive Your important messages. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.